rolls on down the river. Tonight from San Antonio, it's the fourth-ranked Kansas State Wildcats and the Purdue Boilermakers at the Builder Square Alamo Bowl. The best traveling fans in college football have made themselves at home in San Antonio, as more than 25,000 K-State faithful have come from all points of Kansas to the Builder Square Alamo Bowl. It's the Big 12 versus the Big 10. Kansas State taking on Purdue here at the Alamo Dome. Martin Gramatica, you see his numbers, that's incredible. 96 kickoffs and 51 of those touchbacks. Number two, this is Clopton and Randall Lane, the two deep men for the Purdue Boilermakers. K-State won the toss, they deferred, and this one is underway. Gets by Clopton and goes into the end zone. And, well, I think he would have to be. First play from scrimmage, Breeze sets up with a shotgun. They fake the run, Breeze to throw, and he is low and away. Breeze, and he'll have only one running back, Jay Crabtree. They'll have as many as four wide receivers, but they started out this way. Randolph at tight end, Jones, Cox, and Randall Lane, the receivers. And the offensive line, it's a good group. Matt Light is the best of the offensive line. Niedrek right there in the middle. Second down and 10. Puts touch on this one, and the ball is dropped by Isaac Jones. As you take a look at the defense, Joe Bob Clements, Roe McIntosh, and Darren Howard, the defensive front. Maybe the best group of linebackers in America. Oaks, Kelly, and Simino. And in the secondary, it is Butler, Carter, Lamar Chapman, and Cooper, the strong safety. Breeze under pressure, gets it away, has it complete, and that is Chris Daniels for the first down. Gonna have to hurry as linebackers pinch in. Gets it away, got it complete at the 39-yard line. What a stick. 2 of 4, 19 yards. Drew Breeze. They go with a running play. Not much. There's Crabtree. And here we go. Empty backfield. Just Breeze. Steps up, got it, incomplete, and a close to pass interference on Chapman. Punt returns and kick returns of all kinds as it is blocked by K-State. Picked up by the Wildcats and inside the 15-yard line is McGraw, and there is a flag. Offside, it's gonna come Kansas back. State. The Boilers come back to the line of scrimmage. Niedrek over the football, a junior out of LaGrange, Georgia. And it's a quick screen out of the flat, and look at the quickness of the defense. Isaac Jones makes the catch, and Cooper, as you look at Venables, he is also part of that defensive coordinator positioning. And look at the run by Breeze. Going to take it up to the 50-yard line. You see the numbers, and they're incredible. Big Ten passing records galore this year, and keep in mind, he's only a sophomore. Pass knocked down at the line of scrimmage. Pick number 77, Damian McIntosh. Missouri, but he is not doing it here in the early part of the ballgame. Don't know if he's going to be punished for the entire game or not. This punt is going to hit at the one and go into the end zone. And Joe Tiller sighs. This is a very large crowd as you see Michael Bishop for the first time tonight on offense. And they'll go with the running play with Hickson, and he will take it close to the 25-yard line. Bishop, the quarterback, Hickson, and Gouldsby is the fullback out of Dodge City, Kansas. Receivers, very good one. McDonald and also Aaron Lockett. Justin Swift, the tight end. And up front with the offensive line, Ryan Young, the big fella, number 76 on the left side, told us yesterday at lunch he's in the vicinity of 343. He'll try to throw for the first time. Pressure from that defensive front, and here's where he killed you. Most quarterbacks would have been caught for a sack. Two defensive ends are the guys to watch, O'Keefer and Roosevelt Coleman. The linebackers, Fells, who just made the stop, along with Reeves and Lorzell. And then the secondary, Bell and Kennard are the corners. Billy Gustin and Adrian Beasley are the safeties for Purdue. Bishop, quarterback keeper, not gonna have it. The Boilermakers are there to make the stop, but it's Wakori who team. He kicks the ball extremely high. Sutherland is the deep man, and this one's off the side of his foot. And now takes a huge K-State bounce and goes inside the 26-yard line. 9:08 to play, first quarter, second possession by Purdue. Crabtree, and there's just not much there. Offside against K-State twice now because of all the wide receivers and spread formation by Purdue. Breeze gets it away and incomplete. Offside, Kansas State. Nobody in the backfield. Quick pass, got it across the middle, and that's Jones. He will have it for the Purdue first down. So that means also, as you see, the four wide receivers, two safeties out covering as quarterbacks normally would. Oh, they stop and go, and the move was nice. Watch the game, and we thought we would play A&M or maybe Texas or Missouri, but not K-State. Quick throw out in the flat, and they get the quick screen, and this is Jones, and he will take it inside the 45 to the 43, Kansas State. They are 1-3 on third down conversions tonight, and the ball was never snapped on time.
Prior to the snap, false start on the offense. 5 yards, still third down.
And they still have to take it just inside the 39. Empty backfield again. Breeze steps up, going to be caught, sacked by Darren Howard. Tonight was blocked, but Kansas State was offside, and they should have blocked another one, and he ran right by the punter. Fielded at the 13. And the tackle made at the 20-yard line. Bishop, second offensive series for the Wildcats. Going to go up on top. Got a man there, and it is just beyond Aaron Lockett's fingertip. 5:59 left to play. They're going to have to hurry. 3 seconds down to two. Movement all over the place. You can see on the right side as it is thrown complete, and they're still blowing whistles. The reason the players are having to come up and ask him personally what the call is. Draw play. Hickson breaks a tackle. Has five, and who is he attacked from behind by Colvin? Third down. Line to make is the 31. They fake the draw. Pressure is on, and he's sacked, this time by O'Keefer. Yards deep in his own end zone. Wobbly spiral.
Another mistake. Let that ball hit.
Let that ball hit on this hard AstroTurf, and they're going to wind up with an extra 15, almost 20 yards out of it. That's LaGrange, Texas. Play, nothing for Crabtree. Second down at about 13 and a half yards. Blitz, flag is down, and Breeze is going to be tackled in the open field by Howard.
I think it's on David Cohen.
About 14 yards to pick up the first. They need to take it all the way out to the 45. Another flag is down. Breeze lets it go long, and it is complete, almost intercepted.
Here the visiting coach looking at him bouncing.
Well, they've got the return on a very high, good coverage kick. Allen, he'll return it for the 23. And here he goes. 35, 40. You see why he leads the nation. They're going to wind up with a gain of only 13 yards. They give it to the fullback, and Goolsby
can hinder his pass rush ability.
Quick pass intercepted by Purdue, and that's Dustin. And Dustin will take it to the 30-yard line. Bishop makes the tackle. Blitz off the corner. Pass right back in that direction, through it short, and Lane has to go to the AstroTurf. Again from the shotgun. Lofts this one for the end zone. Got a man just beyond the fingertips of Isaac Jones. It is third down. They need to take it to the K-State 20-yard line. 1 of 5 on third down conversions and 9. Not sure they got the playoff. Nope, there comes the flag.
Dead ball. Cross to the snap. Delay of gain on the offense. 5-yard penalty. Still third down.
Trying to get them going. Empty backfield again from the shotgun. Breeze is sacked by Seminole. Second time that they've gotten to him tonight. coming after him again. Very high kick. Off to the left side. Allen calls for his team. And look at this. K-State bounce. Good heavens. It comes all the way back to the 35 and then goes dead at the 33. That's a 7-yard kick. 7 yards is the net. Option play. Back into the open side of the field. Hickson gets a block. 45, and he's out to the 47-yard line. First down, Wildcats. Off the shotgun. Here's Murphy. Loses the football. It is picked up by Purdue. Reeves. And Reeves will take it back inside the 35-yard line.
Willie Fills with a nice hit.
Drew Brees. They snap it from the 33. Drew steps up, knocked down at the line of scrimmage twice. McIntosh.
Fans are trying their best, but it looks like a ball club that is not focusing.
Brees off the mark on Adlin, and maybe for good reason, because it was good coverage. Off 4 of 8. He is now 2 of his last 7. That's Cox in motion. Coming back to the lower part of your screen. Quarterback draw. 5, 10. Boy, does he take a shot from Cooper. And let's see. He will have the first down. That is the end of the first quarter. So let's take a break. Kansas State nothing. Purdue nothing. And the Boilers are threatening. We'll be right back. Blitz coming right up the middle. They roll the pocket. Can he get it away? Yes, got a man open. His tight end at Stratton. And he steps out of bounds at the 10-yard line. First and goal. Again, empty backfield. Nobody behind Brees. He takes it from under center. Drills it, and it should have been caught. And that's 2 passes tonight.
Here's another offside penalty against Kansas State. So that's going to benefit Purdue again as the ball's moved to the 5-yard line.
Now they're moving into the K-State end of the field. That's a reason Brees is having to come up. Blitz right up the middle. Looking, delivers, touchdown, and he's got Chris Daniels.
Keith Black, and then comes back and runs a curl.
Extra point attempt, that's Travis Dorch, and he knocks it home. So let's take a timeout as you take one more look at Daniels with the touchdown reception. Let it go, but Murphy is a 4-2-2 sprinter. He's the fastest man on a K-State team, and he gets it 5 yards deep, and his teammates say nope. So Kansas State will go from their own 20-yard line, and now trailing by a touchdown, 7-0. Pressure from the backside, and he is going to be sacked again by Colvin. Ball came loose, but the officials say no, he was down at the 10-yard line. But they say down, but it is Purdue's football, Mike. They have awarded it. They have awarded it to Purdue.
Then compared to former Purdue and 49er Tina Turner from the outside. Michael Bishop arguing the point, but number 59, Roosevelt Colvin, they're blocking him with 2 players. That's Justin it. Swift, the tight end, stayed in on him.
Well, what an opportunity for the Boilermakers. First down just outside the 10-yard line. Brees drills it. Incomplete. That was Isaac Jones, the man he was looking for.
We'll find out how good we are against a good Kansas State football team.
Well, I'm going to tell you something, Mike. I don't know why, if he's having trouble in these lights or what, but that's 3 footballs that Jones has had hit him right in the hands tonight.
Well, he hadn't missed many during the year, 72 receptions.
Quarterback draw, and Brees spins off at the 2-yard line and make it the 3. Third down and 2 for the Boilermakers. Going to have to hurry. 1 second, they just got it off. Brees' pass. Dropped this time by Daniels.
Ron, I'm not sure they got it off.
Cross the snap, got the lay of game on the offense. 5 yards.
And they'll get that third down back.
That one will not go in the books that way because of the penalty. Third down and 7. Pumps it. Now delivers and knocked away and incomplete. Trying to go to Randall Lane. Travis Dorch, 13 of 19 this year. It's a 25-yard attempt. They get it down, and the kick, he squeezes it in on that left side. Let's take a break. If you just joined us, a little surprised, well, I think everybody is. 10-0, Boilermakers over K-State. Here comes the kick. Last one by Button was in the end zone. This one is returnable, and this is Murphy at the goal line. He is a 4-2-2 sprinter. and he ran into his own blocker, and is going to be stopped just short in sync, but then they turned it over. Bishop going to take the ball for maybe a gain of one.
Not getting into position offensively and defensively. That's where they're short.
Short drop. It's a quarterback draw. This is a design play as he'll take it out of the 35. Well, that's his longest run of the night. It's a gain of eight. Here comes the pressure from the outside, and they throw the screen. Hickson, and that is a nice recovery defensively. Again, the ball is not long, but this one is fielded, and the tackle made immediately on special teams. Boy, look at his field position average. This is one of the worst for Purdue. They stretch it. Chapman tries to bounce it outside, and that's the longest gainer by the running back to everybody else, an underclassman. From a shotgun. Gets it away and right through the hands of Gabe Cox.
Because guys are worried about their knees for the beach.
They get a little frustrated. You're right. Breeze steps up, buys some time, and just throws that one into the turf. It was kick. The ball goes to his hands. Good heavens, what else can happen? Picked up by K-State and dropped. They battle for it at the one and recovered. Nope, still not recovered. At the one-foot line.
That may be the play that wakes up Kansas State.
Quarterback sneak. No signal.
Yes.
Gonna throw the fade to the corner. Touchdown, McDonald. The extra point. And he got it. 9:49 left until halftime. So let's take a break. Our new score, Purdue 10, Kansas State 7. We'll be right back. That's a lot of start and stammers.
Yeah. Start and stops.
Start and stammer and stop. Clopton. He's free. Clopton is finally going to be tackled at the 49-yard line. But great field position for Drew Brees and Purdue. Quick pass, and it's that slip screen again, and Jones going to be stopped at around the 45-yard line. That one hit at the line of scrimmage. It 9 of 23, 62 yards and a touchdown for Drew Brees. Third down, and they need to take it to the 40-and-a-half-yard line. Option play. Brees keeps it. Going to have the first down.
I think too many men on the field for Kansas State.
Yeah. This Purdue offense is beginning to do just what they wanted to do against K-State, and that has had them confused. Ball is hit. Was it a forward pass? An incomplete forward.
We have an incomplete pass on the play. There's no flag on the play.
Here comes the blitz again. Got a man. With the extra point. And I think that is a huge answer by Purdue to come right back after they had handed a gift. Button with the kick. It's returnable. Kicks it to the right side. And this is going to be David Allen. Ooh, you could hear the contact up here. Bishop deep in the pocket. Flag comes down. It is tipped and incomplete, and that's going to be offensive holding. Offensive coordinator told us.
Holding on the offense. Half the distance. Still first down.
Yeah, both did. Bishop rolls the pocket. way too high and almost intercepted.
As Roosevelt does. That's his advantage now.
But remember, you see him holding up the hands. A holding in the end zone would be a safety. I don't know if that's what he's signaling or not. Quick shovel pass. Back into the middle. Good heavens, what a hit on David Allen. Bishop, and he is going to be sacked by Colvin again. I mean, number 59 has done everything. Runs with 6 minutes and 50 seconds left until the halftime. Great high coverage kick. Good gracious. All the way back to the 33-yard line, and he's down to come over to San Antonio from Austin.
Dead ball. Cross to the snap. False start on the offense. 5 yards.
They play with a first down and 15. Got it. It is intercepted by Cooper on a ball that should have been caught, and it goes right through the arms of the receiver. Allen, the tailback. He gets the pitch off the option. And Purdue covers it nicely. He still breaks a tackle, and he's still free. Finally, John Reeves. The ball just outside the 20 of Purdue. 6:20 left until halftime. And he said, that was good. Let's do it again. But this time he gets pummeled.
He doesn't necessarily mean he's going to throw the football.
No, it sure doesn't. Well, he got the snap as he was coming up to take the ball from under center.
Ron, again, a lack of concentration.
Did they get it away? I think so. Swings the pass. Almost intercepted, and Bell was thinking 6 points. 54 of 70 field goals in his career. Ball is down, and the ball is blocked.
Roosevelt Colvin.
Colvin has, right now, if you take the voting, Mike, no one else is close. He's your player of the game. Crabtree is the setback. Breeze lobs it. Intercepted by Kansas State, and that's Carter. Deshaun Carter takes it right back. From the 46, Bishop drills it. Complete, McDonald.
There's no official around.
Now they're saying incomplete.
Just, boy, I tell you what, it looked like Darnell McDonald caught that football.
Well, Corey came in and really put a lick.
Well, he had that football.
Quarterback draw. Tries to get it outside, and Chuki Wakore, 0 for 5 and third down conversions. Bishop's pass got this one complete. Tackle is broken by McDonald, and he will have the Wildcat first down. There it was. It was Wakore as the quick pass. Three seconds, down to two on the play clock. Gets it away. Puts up the fade route, and it is caught out of bounds. No contact, but until last week.
Until last week.
David Allen, the setback. He gets the ball. Breeze by a tackle. Has five and counted off it close to 10 yards. It'll be plenty for the first down. His offensive team looks a little bit more in sync as we get toward a halftime. Pressure from the backside, and he's going to be sacked. O'Keefer this time. Three times that Bishop has been sacked. Sets deep in the pocket. O'Keefer coming after him again. They pick him up, and Bishop just throws it for the end zone, and it is knocked away by Purdue. 17-7, Purdue leads it. 1:17 to play until halftime. Bishop still padding. Here comes the pressure. Again, it's Wakore. Gets it away. Throws to the end zone, and it is intercepted by Purdue, and that's Beasley.
Ron, he had Brian Goosby in the middle of the football field wide open. Just didn't get enough on the football.
So four turnovers in this first half by Kansas State. And this is Crabtree. takes it close to the 30-yard line.
Strong statement after a disastrous bowl season last year. Miami and Virginia Tech both look.
Clock is running to 28, now 27, and he will just go down to one knee. At halftime, the Boilermakers, huge underdogs in this ball game, are going to take a 10-point lead toward the intermission. So it's halftime with our score, 17-7 Purdue. Now with the new Dodge halftime report, let's rejoin Chris Fowler out in Tempe, Arizona. Chris?
We need to start playing.
Twice this year, K-State was down at halftime as this goes to Murphy, 5 yards deep. He will not return it. Ryan Young had his hands pulled in that first half as you look at the run, and that's close to 10 yards by David Allen, averaging 9 yards a carry. He has 36 on 4 attempts right now. Here he comes again. Has 5, has 10, counted off at 15, 16, and now at 19 yards. Pressure, and he's just going to throw this one away. But not at the expense of our young people.
You're going to have to get a new microphone.
Big opening again, and Allen inside the 35. It again, and this time nothing doing. Lorzel. Well, this has been a very good date. First down and 20. Bishop rolls the pocket. Now going to throw back to the other side, and he's got it complete. Nice job in the comeback by McDonald, and they almost pick up.
Hats off to the job Bill Snyder and the president John Weefall's done.
It was a first down, and with the running play, O'Keefer again right on it.
They tried to block Roosevelt Colvin with two and haven't been able to.
Bishop on the pitch. Good hit by Beasley. You could see those heads. Chop. Block. Second down, they got to take it all the way to the 14-yard line. Bishop under pressure. Now he's going to run it. In the open field is tackled by one leg by John Reeves. And as we mentioned, they got to take it to the 13.5-yard line to get the first down from the shotgun. Bishop, they roll the pocket back to the open side and throws it complete. Good heavens, what a hit on Lockett.
Ineligible receiver downfield for Kansas State. Well, Ron, I just watched that replay, and I just don't believe that's a penalty.
Bishop sets very deep this time and goes for the end zone, and that ball is going to be knocked down.
Misses, he gets a good field position up.
They kick it for the far sideline. This is a good hanging spiral, and it's going to hit just 1 yard deep in the end zone. The safety blitz, and they throw the play that should work against him, and he couldn't get it back inside as he could have cut the thing back inside. It had a chance of adding some real big yardage. Breeze, they want to throw back on the screen, and they do, and Crabtree, there's nothing. Seminole, what a nice defensive play out of Oak Brook, Illinois. It's Isaac Jones in motion, bottom of the screen. Breeze, quarterback draw, nothing doing. Third quarter, Purdue, a 2-touchdown and in some quarters more underdog in this ballgame, up by 10. Breeze, long throw, got it complete, and Daniels will pick up the first down, waiting for the return. High pass over his head. Second one we've had tonight, and K-State had to return on it, and he missed it. And K-State will recover it for a touchdown. Lines up. That extra point is no good. Gramatica yanks it. First one that he has missed all year, and consider this as we go to break. The only two touchdowns K-State has in this ballgame are from errant snaps from center. We'll be right back. It has been havoc as far as the long snap. Sandifer with a couple just a little too tall. That's cost him two touchdowns. Clapton. Tell you what, this little guy right here makes things happen. On the sideline, number 20, Chris Daniels, who is a wide receiver, was practicing long snaps a moment ago. We'll look and see if they use him on the next punt. Crabtree, maybe one. Breeze, got it complete. Close to the 40 is Sutherland for Drew Brees tonight. Sets, now he's going to run, and that won't last very long because they collapse. Kelly is there.
Your best football players, but your inspirational leaders on the sideline.
Seminole, the only guy in the lineup at that linebacking spot, throws it complete. That's Jones, and not going to have the first down. It's just over a yard for the first down. Breeze tripped over his lineman and got it away, and it's intercepted, and that's Chapman. Breeze tripped over his guard and still tried to get it away. David Allen is the tailback. Gouldsby, number 30, the fullback. And they go with the running game. And Allen tries to move the pile, and they push him back after a gain to the 48. Rushing yardage, Purdue. Of course, the sacks come off that, but a minus 42. Bishop, it is a design play, and Lorzel is right there to... There he comes, and Coleman will make the sack. Good heavens, they knew he was there. They put a second man there. O'Keeper helped out. Off the side of his foot. Fair catch is called for, and Sutherland makes it. First and 10. Breeze steps up. Got it complete at the 28. He's being pushed back. It'll be interested to see. Now, they're going to spot Daniels down at the 26. Under 3 minutes to play third quarter. Here comes the blitz. Pressure up the middle, and he puts some air under it, and he's got it complete, and that's Sutherland. And they move the chains. The ball just outside the K-State 45. It's Crabtree in motion. They swing the pass out. Nice job defensively, but he breaks the tackle, and that's Isaac Jones.
That they shift Vinny Sutherland out and got him against the linebacker. They got exactly what they want with him.
And that's who he's looking at, and the ball is tipped and knocked out at the line of scrimmage. McIntosh, third down, and they need to take it to the 35 of Kansas State. Breeze got his pass off incomplete. Very high. Runs away from it, and it is down by Purdue at the 1 yard line. And you can't get lazy on any step. They'll go with the running game, and it's going to be Allen, only the fullback. Gouldsby is there, and Paris, number 87, comes in at wide receiver. Ball is fumbled, it's in the end zone. Touchdown, David Nugent. Nugent, David Nugent with the touchdown.
Never got the football.
Kick is good. And with 52 seconds left in the third quarter, our new score, Purdue 24 and Kansas State 13. And right now is extremely proud. Here comes Button's kickoff. Murphy, 2 yards deep, he'll return it. Remember I told you this is the 4-2 sprinter. And he ran right into the man. Bishop's pass. Paris in and out of his hands. Sets deep, and the ball is tipped at the line of scrimmage, and O'Keefer. K-State losing those three fumbles tonight. That is an Alamo Bowl record. Bishop's pass, intercepted, and it's Gustin again. His second pickoff of the night, first and goal, Purdue. From the shotgun, Breeze, incomplete. 16 seconds left in the third quarter. That pass complete to Jones, but not for very much. incomplete. Stratton, the tight end. It's a 26-yard attempt. Dortch is one of one tonight. Good pass. Kick is up, and he squeezes it through. Butler was close for a block, and with 4 seconds remaining in the third quarter, we'll hold it right here. Every time you kick it, if you can't get it in the end zone, you're playing with fire because of that number three back there. But this one's far enough. I don't think he'll return it. Well, he's going to. From 5 yards deep in the end zone, runs into his own man, and still takes it out to the 36-yard line. That is the end of the third quarter. As we head to the final 15 minutes, Roosevelt Colvin, Chiki O'Keefer, and Chuki Wakori have had a big part in this ball game. We'll give you the three quarters statistics in just a moment as they go with a running play. That's Hickson, and he pushes the pile. Bishop sets deep under pressure, and he's sacked by O'Keefer. Times third down, and they have to take it out to the 46-yard line to keep this drive going. Bishop throws very long, and it is caught by Paredes. It winds up as a plus 53. Quarterback draw. Bishop goes down hard just inside the 10. David Allen at left guard, and then he disappears. He takes a pretty good hit. Bishop in the option play gets a block at the 5, and they will have the first down as David Allen gets belted up. First and goal, Wildcats. Allen again. Right side, touchdown, K-State. And that last touchdown. It's a good pass and knocks this one home. So there's a timeout. 11:59 left in our ball game. It's a 7-point Purdue lead. And here's the kickoff. Line drive, and it's going to go in and out of the end zone. Breeze puts some air under this one, and in and out of the hands of Sutherland. We've got it unofficially. 8 drops with that one right there. Breeze lobs it too high and should have, almost intercepted. Third down. They are 2 of 13. They have missed their last 6 third down conversions. Breeze puts air into this one. Got Jones open, and he dropped the football. I don't believe this. This young man might have scored. Good heavens. They're coming after him, and he gets it away. Good driving spiral. Flag is down as they rough the kicker. And Allen will be tackled at the 45.
We're running into the kicker. It's a 5-yard penalty. 5 yards from the previous spot. We'll replay fourth down.
Driving spiral. Best kick of the night. Adam retreats to the 22. There's a block in the back and a flag. And Allen may score on this, but they're going to have to call it back. Well, he doesn't. He goes down at the 15, but there was a clear block in the back. Yeah. And it is very hard for that offensive unit to hear the signals. Kelly, going to run it. Or Bishop, I beg your pardon.
Kansas State's concentration has not been good.
Bishop, going to be tackled again. Colvin. Pass over the middle. It is tipped and almost intercepted by Lorzell. It's back deep for Purdue. Good high coverage kick. This is a dandy. Bearcats a signal for it and made at the 37-yard line. Crabtree takes it for short yardage. Here comes the blitz in the middle, and they give it to Crabtree, and he breaks it. Crabtree will have the first down, and he's still going. First down, they put the ball at the 47. They keep it on the ground again. Crabtree has 5, has 10, counted off at around 15 yards.
And that's what's happening to Kansas State.
They go with the third running play in a row. This could be a Purdue record. Crabtree, 9 carries, 44 yards now. They fake it to him. Breeze gets his pass away, complete.
They're going to stick with it and keep running, Ron, and keep being successful.
Yep, you're right. It's Sherman Oaks, I believe, Adrian, is where that high school started. Second down. Breeze sets nicely, gets it complete, and stepping out of bounds is Randall Lane.
Frustrates you.
Breeze. Well, Travis, a freshman out of Bozeman, Montana, 6'6", 192 pounds, has one from 25 and 26 to the good pass, and this one is right down the Alamo. So the Purdue Boilermakers, with that field goal, push their lead back to 10 points. And we'll take a break with 6:44 remaining. The Big Ten right now up by 10. And he wants the football if he can get it. Let's see if it's returnable. Yep, it is. It's in the field of play from the 4. Tackled inside the 15 by Stelma. First down from the 13-yard line. Bishop, deep retreat, pumps it. Going long, got a man open. And McDonald makes the catch. Flag goes down, but he will score it easily from 87 yards. Let's call it 88 yards.
Billy Gustin tried to run into him to get the pass interference, but Darnell McDonald, with good concentration, brought that pass in for the score.
On the defense. By rule, we have a touchdown. Penalty is applied.
And he does. Could pull his team to within 3. Clapped him 2 yards deep, and he'll go down on one knee.
And I think it's hurt him tonight in this ballgame. They're trying to get back in this thing.
Crabtree is going to be stopped for about a yard lost. Running play again. Crabtree takes a real shot. They're 2 of 15 on third down conversions, and they've missed their last 8. Catch, and also Jones, I beg your pardon, low pass from center, gets his kick away, and this spiral's not going to turn over. Allen from the 42. .402 to play. And K-State can smell momentum going in their direction. Here comes the quarterback draw. Still on his feet. Bishop will take it close to the first down. They did move the chains. It is first down from the Boilermaker 16. Hickson breaks by a tackle, breaks by a second one as they try to take the ball away at the 11. Bishop, quarterback draw again. Straight ahead with the quarterback sneak, and they will have the first down just inside the 5.
You've seen a different Michael Bishop in that last period of time.
Purdue led 27-13 with 4 seconds left in the third quarter. Second and goal. Hickson met in the backfield as they got penetration. So here they come to the line of scrimmage. It is third down for the Wildcats. Throws for the end zone. Touchdown, Swift. The
check that. Offsides, Purdue, and looking up at the clock. Got a minute, 24 seconds to work with. Let's see if Gramatica kicks this one, yep, into the base of the end zone. They'll not return it, but they still have 1:24 left. Pass is low. That, he's going to do a lot of winning for the Boilermakers. Steps up, gets it away, and that one is too low. 2 of 16 third down conversions, and they have missed their last nine. Breeze's pass got it complete, and they'll have the first down. Gets this one complete. That's Randall Lane. Breeze. Oh, my goodness, just beyond Chris Daniels, and a flag is down.
The intended receiver.
Well, they have been considerable. Breeze gonna run it, and he's got a lot of running room. Gonna take it as far as he can, and he did get out of bounds very wisely in being called for a clip. Breeze lobs it for the end zone, got him there. Touchdown, Isaac Joe. Extra point is good. A three-point game with 30 seconds left. And I mean the K-State bench and their side of the field is sitting in stunned silence. They cannot believe. You see his numbers, and he is relacing that shoe. And there's the kick on the ground. And it's bobbled for a moment. Now Murphy trying to find some place to run. And he is going to be hemmed in at the 11-yard line. And Bishop back in the end zone, rolling it. Flag has come down way behind the play.
Can't lose too much yardage from the five.
This city does a great job for sports event.
Excellent.
Bishop rolls the pocket, throws as he is hit, and this one's just up in the air for grabs. And it is tipped, and it is not intercepted. 7 seconds. Bishop runs up into the pocket. 2 seconds, down to one, gets his pass away, and it is going to be intercepted. John Reeves with the interception is knocked out of bounds, and this one is over. And Joe Tiller gets a cool bath, and this is an excited Purdue football team.
Again, Ron, you got to credit Purdue. They came to play, and they played, and they made that drive that won the football game. And hats off to both these coaching staffs. They've had great years.
So Drew Brees to Isaac Jones, and that was the difference maker.